So in this video, we will start entering the data in the spreadsheet. So you can select any cell and start typing. It will fill the data. Employee code. Press tab to move the right side of the cell and enter the next text number or date. So right now I'm entering the heading, so it would be the name, then date of birth, then salary, and press enter. So when you press tab, it will move to the right side of the cell, and when you press enter, it will come to the first cell where in the first cell of the next row where you have start typing. So this is the best practice to entering the data in the spreadsheet. Now I will enter the code. 100, name Ram Singh, date of birth 1st January 1991. Press tab. Now salary is 5000. Press enter. Again it will move to the next row and it will come to the first cell. You can easily select any cell by mouse, but you can use the arrow keys from the keyboard, right, up, down, sides. So when you press one time up arrow key, it will move to the upper side of the cell, then right arrow key to move one cell to the right side. If you press again and again, it will move one cell right side. So by that way you can move the cell in the sheet. By that way you can enter as many as data you want. You can also feed the series of the numbers by dragging this one. Come over here and come to this highlighted corner, put the cursor over here and left click over here. When you drag, so you will get 100, but I want to increase series, so just undo it by pressing Control Z. And now press Control and click over here, and now you drag the downside, so the number would be increased by 1, or it would be in the incremental series. Okay, we will discuss in coming videos in depth about this feature. So it will help you to reduce the entering the data. Now you can easily enter the name, date of birth, and the salary. So I'll feed that one for you. I have entered some data. Now we will do some formatting in the numbers and the date as well. I can see the date is coming in a different format. You can't understand the date. It is actually the 17th January 1991, but I want to change it so the user can see the date exactly and he won't be confused. So just select the cells you want to make the formatting and come to the format tab. And here we have some options for formatting. You can get the formats of numbers. Here we have some default date addresses, date formats. Here also I have the format. If you click over here, it will change like this. But we have some more options for formatting. Come here over here and come to the more formats and click over the more dates and the time format. Click over here, and here also we have a list of formats for the different type of dates, so you can select which is fulfill your purpose. So I would like to select this one and click the apply. So now user easily understand it's 1st January 1991. So this is the options for formatting the dates, so you can do and you can do the practice and select the different kind of date format. Now we will move to the number format. Select the cells from the mouse you want to change the format, and now come to the format tab and come to the numbers. So here I have options in the currency, scientific, percentage, accounting, financial, currencies, currency rounded. There's so many options. Again I'll come to the more options, and here more currency option, because this amount, the salary amount, is in currency. So I would like to select the currency amount. We can also have the custom number format, which we will discuss later on. Now click on the more currencies, and here I have more currencies. So I'm from India, so I would like to select the Indian currency, so I would change it to the India rupees. So once you type the country name, it will come automatically over here, and select that one and click apply. So now I have the number in the currency format, and we can easily identify. So dear friend, by that way you can enter the data in the spreadsheets